Have you struggled to view the analytics for individual videos on your YouTube channel? Well, now you don't have to anymore, because YouTube now displays an analytics button right below your video. Stay tuned while I show you how to find the new YouTube analytics button for individual videos and the top stats you should be tracking so you can get more views and subscribers. My name is Herman Drost from DrostDesigns.com. If you want to grow your audience on YouTube and generate traffic, leads, and sales on autopilot, hit the subscribe button and click the bell notification icon so you'll be notified whenever I upload a new video. Here's how to find the new analytics button for your YouTube videos. Click on Video Manager under Creator Studio and select the video that you wish to get the stats for. Or if you know the title of your video, you can just enter your title in the search box here. Once you've selected the video, just click on the thumbnail. Now you can see YouTube's new analytics button right below your video. You immediately get an overview of the stats for your individual video for the last 28 days. Here's the title of my video, here's the accumulated watch time, here's the average view duration, here's the number of views, top geographies, traffic sources, gender, and playback locations. So what are the top stats that you should be looking for to get more views and subscribers? Number one is traffic sources. It shows you where most of your traffic is coming from. So top three sources for this video is other YouTube features, channel pages, and suggested videos. You can click on any one of these to get more details. So if I click on suggested videos, these are the videos from other channels where I get traffic to this video. Number two, audience retention. Average view duration is 2.31 minutes. This is the estimated average minutes watched per view for the selected content, date range, region, and other filters. Average percentage viewed is 36%. This is the average percentage of a video your audience watches per view. For absolute audience retention, you can see that the amount of viewers decreases as the video continues. The absolute audience retention curve shows the number of views for every moment of a video as a percentage of the total number of video views. Pay close attention to the first 15 seconds of every video. That's when viewers are most likely to drop off. If I click on relative audience retention, relative audience retention compares your video to similar YouTube videos. The relative audience retention shows a video's ability to keep viewers compared to all YouTube videos of similar length. If the graph is higher, it indicates how many more viewers kept watching your video for that time frame compared to the same time frame in other YouTube videos. So as you can see, my relative audience retention is above average for most of the duration of the video. Audience retention is one of the top ranking factors on YouTube. If 50% of your viewers watch your video all the way through to the end, then your video will rank in search and YouTube suggested videos. Number three, new metrics. If you want to view the new metrics for your individual video, click on Impressions and CTR. Enter the title of your video in the search box. Click the video title. Here's the overview of this video. I've got audience retention, likes, dislikes, latest activity, my top traffic sources. If I click Reach Viewers, top here I've got impressions, which is how many times my video thumbnail was shown to viewers. I've got impressions click-through rate, which is views per impression shown. This measures how often viewers watch the video after seeing an impression or a thumbnail. Then I've got video views compared with the previous period, and I've got unique views, which is the estimated number of people that watched my content within the selected date range. In this case, it's 28 days. Here you can see the impressions that led to my watch time. So I got the number of impressions, got 29.3% from YouTube recommending my content. I've got 24.2% recommended on the homepage, 5.1% recommended on the watch page. This is 298 views for the selected date range, which is last 28 days. And then I've got an average view duration of 2.32%. Average view duration refers to the estimated average minutes watched per view for the selected content, date range, region, and other filters. And I've got a watch time in the last 28 days of 756 minutes. So I've got top traffic source types. I've got the external traffic sources. And I've got the suggested videos traffic source, which is the traffic coming from other people's channels, and the traffic coming from YouTube search. If you want to learn more about the new metrics for your YouTube videos, click the card icon. If you're struggling to come up with new ideas for your YouTube videos, click the link in the card. You'll also discover how to schedule your videos so you don't have to be there to upload them manually. If you want to grow your audience on YouTube and generate traffic, leads, and sales on autopilot, click the round subscribe button below and check out the related videos. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.